Hello, welcome to Genius Channel. We are going to see some EVCR physics questions of NBA. So all of you please read the question number 61. Question number 61. A man is sitting in a train which is moving with a velocity 60 kilometer per hour. His speed with respect to the train is. A man is sitting in a train which is moving with a velocity of 60 kilometer per hour. His speed with respect to train is 10 by 3 meter per second, 60 meter per second, infinite, zero. What is his speed with respect to train? Okay, so our answer is very easy, isn't it? So the man is sitting in the train. So he's sitting in the train means his velocity is what, same as that of the train, isn't it? Because he is not moving inside the train. He is sitting in the train. So his speed and the speed of the train is same. Okay, so what is their relative speed? Speed with respect to train is asked. Means relative speed. So what is that? That is zero. Option D, zero is the correct answer. Okay, so I'm saying a few more information along with this. See, if two objects are moving towards each other, one is having velocity V1, other one is having velocity V2, then their relative velocity, that means velocity of one object with respect to another, that is V1 plus V2. Now, if two objects are moving in the same direction, then relative speed is V1 minus V2. Okay, so that you have to know. If two objects are moving towards each other means opposite direction is which. So opposite direction means they will have velocity V1 plus V2. Same direction means V1 minus V2. Okay. So moving to the next question. Question number 62. Two forces, one of 3 Newton and another of 4 Newton are applied on a standard 1 kilogram body placed on a horizontal and frictionless surface simultaneously along x-axis and y-axis respectively as shown in the figure. The magnitude of the resultant acceleration is. So we have two forces, 3 Newton and 4 Newton applied on a standard body placed on horizontal and frictionless surface simultaneously along x-axis and y-axis respectively as shown in the figure. So 3 Newton along the x-axis and 4 Newton along the y-axis. We have to find the magnitude of resultant acceleration. Please try all of you. Comment your answers once you get it. Options are 7 meter per second square, 1 meter per second square, 5 meter per second square, 7 meter per second square. That is easy. Please do. First, you have to find the resultant force because two forces are acting, isn't it? So, resultant force, first of all, you have to find out. Now, see here, both the forces are acting perpendicular. Isn't it? Because angle between these two forces is 90 degrees, isn't it? So, how can you find the resultant force? If the angle between two vectors is 90 degree, how can you find the resultant? You need the resultant force, isn't it? So resultant force is nothing but root of 3 square plus 4 square. Resultant force is equal to root of 3 square plus 4 square. That is root of 25, you will get 5. So resultant force is 5 Newton. Now what you need? You need the resultant acceleration. We know F is equal to ma. So A is equal to F by m. Now force we got 5. Mass is given as 1 kilogram. So it is 5 meter per second square. Pi divided by 1, that is 5 meter per second square. That is option C. 5 meter per second square. So what did we do? We first of all found out the resultant force, then resultant force, isn't it? Resultant force, we have found out F, and from that we found out acceleration because mass is already given. The answer is option C, 5 meter per second square. So moving to the next one. Next question. Question number 63. Question number 63. In SI unit of force, Newton is given by, in SI unit of force, Newton N is given by, where M stands for meter, S stands for second. Okay, so you need to just find out what is the definition of Newton in SI unit. Okay, what is that? So what is Newton? That is, Newton stands for force, isn't it? For Newton is the center of force. Now F is force, we know ma. So that is mass means in kilogram. A means meter per second square, isn't it? So 1 kilogram into 1 meter per second square is equal to 1 Newton. So we have 1 kilogram meter per second square. 1 kilogram meter per second square. 1 Newton is equal to 1 kilogram meter per second square. Clear? Understood? Okay. So moving to the next question, question number 64. Which one of the following statements is not correct? Which one of the following statements is not correct? If the velocity and acceleration have opposite sign, the object is slowing down. If the velocity is zero at an instant, acceleration should also be zero at that instant. If the velocity is zero for a time interval, then acceleration is zero at any instant within the time interval. If the object and velocity have opposite sign, if the position and velocity have opposite sign, the object is moving towards the origin. Okay, so you have to find out which is the incorrect statement, which is not correct. Listen, velocity and acceleration. The velocity and acceleration statement I'm reading. If the velocity and acceleration have opposite sign, the object is slowing down. That is correct statement, isn't it? Velocity and acceleration having opposite sign means object is slowing down. That is correct, isn't it? That is correct. If the velocity is zero at an instant, acceleration should also be zero at that instant. That is wrong. This is a wrong statement. If velocity is zero for a time interval, then acceleration at any instant within the time interval, zero, that is also correct. The position and velocity have opposite sign, then the object is moving towards the origin. So that is also correct. So the incorrect statement is option B. Incorrect statement is option B. So 64, answer is option B. Okay. So moving to the next question. Question number 65. A brass ball is tied to a thin wire. A brass ball is tied to a thin wire and swung so as to move uniformly in a horizontal circle. Which of the following statement in this regard is or are true? A brass ball is tied to a thin wire and swung so as to move uniformly in a horizontal circle. Which one of the following statements in this regard is or are true? The ball moves with constant velocity. The ball moves with constant speed. The ball moves with constant acceleration. The magnitude of the acceleration of the ball is constant. You have to choose which is the correct statement. You have to choose which is the correct statement. So you have only one and three, 1, 2 and 3, 2 and 4, which is the correct statement. Okay. So I want all of you to try that. Please try. Please read the statements very clearly and then answer the question. I'll give you 30 seconds for reading it clearly and understanding and tell, comment your answers. Okay, so first thing we'll see, the ball moves with constant velocity. That is wrong, isn't it? Why? Because direction is changing. When it is moving like this, this is moving in a circular path, its direction is changing. Obviously, we know velocity has both direction and magnitude. Okay, so in a circular motion, velocity cannot be constant. Its direction is changing. Ball moves with constant speed. That is a correct statement. Constant speed, we can say. Without any, we are not giving any force, we are not giving any acceleration. It is moving its own. So, they have already told you uniformly. So, we can say it is constant speed. That is correct. Now, coming to acceleration, we cannot say that the ball is having constant acceleration. Why we can't say? Because here, as I've already told, at every instant, direction is changing. At every instant, direction is changing. So we cannot say that acceleration is constant. So that is also wrong because acceleration is also a vector quantity. We need to consider the direction also. Next is magnitude of acceleration of the ball is constant. That is correct. Magnitude is constant. Its direction is changing. Even though direction is changing, magnitude is constant. Direction is changing. Magnitude is constant. Okay. As we all know, a vector quantity will have direction as well as magnitude. Okay. So, in this case, magnitude is a constant because direction goes on changing. So, which are the correct statements? 2 and 4. So, which is the option that is required? Option D, 2 and 4. Option D, 2 and 4. Yes, these were the options. So, we choose the correct statements are true statements are statement 2, statement 4. So, option D, 2 and 4. Okay, So we'll move to the next question. Question number 66. Question number 66. A racing car accelerates on a straight line. A racing car accelerates on a straight line from rest to a speed of 50 meter per second in 25 seconds, assuming uniform acceleration of the object throughout. The distance covered will be. Okay, so we are seeing the question number 66. So here you have to find the distance covered. Distance is what you have to find out. Distance covered. Okay. So a racing car accelerates on a straight line from rest to a speed. So they are telling rest, isn't it? Rest means initial velocity is equal to zero. Then its speed increased to 50 meter per second. So final velocity is 50 meter per second. Then what is the time given? Time is equal to 25 seconds. You are asked to find the distance covered. Okay. So we have T is also there. So it's a direct question. Use the formula and tell me the answer, all of you. Please try that. So mainly we have three equations. V is equal to u plus at. S is equal to ut plus half at square. V square is equal to u square plus 2as. Okay. So check which equation we can use here and find out the answer. Comment your answer. Okay, so how do you do? See, distance, that is the letter S, isn't it? So in this equation, we have U, T, but we don't have A. So we have to first find A. A is equal to V minus U by T. V is 50 minus U is 0 by T is 25. So you will get it as 2 meter per second square. Acceleration is 2 meter per second square. Now what you need? We need displacement, isn't it? The distance S is equal to ut, u is 0, t 25 plus half a is 2, t is 25 square. So I'll get S is equal to 625 meters. S is equal to 625 meters. Okay, so what is the total equations we have used here? So these three equations you have to by heart, basic equation that you are studying in your 10th standard. Or a 9th or 10th in NCERT, 9th standard, you are studying this equation. NCERT 9th, you have studied this equation, then again in 11th. So this is a basic, these are the basic equations that you study. So using these basic equations, generally questions will come. Simple questions will come, direct substitution questions will have come. So you should be knowing to do this, okay. So here the answer is 625 meter. So that is option. So it's 625 meter, that is option A. Option A is the correct answer. Option A. Okay, so see you everyone in another video with some more questions. Thank you so much.